Hi, AT from CNC at Home. I wanted to go into LightBurn today and just show a cool feature that was added a little bit ago, but we really haven't talked about it, and has to do with their grid function. If I take this Celtic knot and select the whole thing, one of the things I can do is go into my create array and make a bunch of these so I can grid them out. I'll just make a 2x2 grid on here. Plain and simple, not a big deal, but these are separate objects. So if I come in here and select this, must be grouped. Yeah, so if I ungroup this, I can come in here and select just part of this one and delete it. And there's nothing wrong with that, that's fine. So let's undo all of that. We'll select this again and we'll go into grid. We'll do our 2x2 grid. This time, down here, we'll create a virtual array. So I'll turn this on and click OK. What that's done is it's basically made copies of my original, but it's still tied to the original. Any changes that I make to this original image will then show up in all of these copies. So for instance, if I come in here and I take this center part and delete it, it's deleted from all four images. So I know that doesn't look like much, but it's really kind of a cool thing. Any kind of editing that I want to do after I've gridded this, I can do to just this one image and it will take place in all four of these. If I want to change what I've done with my grid, I just highlight my original, I right-click on it, and I can edit my array. That just brings up my normal array settings, so maybe I want to go 3 wide, and it still has the virtual array selected on here. I also have an option when I right-click to exit array, and that basically undoes the array that I've set up. I know it's kind of a simple feature that can really save you a bunch of time if you're going to grid things out and you maybe aren't quite done editing, that sort of thing. I hope you enjoyed this look at the array feature and how we can use it. If you like this, give it a thumbs up. And remember to subscribe to the channel and enjoy doing your CNC at home projects.
Oops.